Hi everyone. So I wish I got more of a descriptive video on this, but I really wanted to share some insight as well as this project because I think it came out really nice and it's pretty easy and you could obviously do your own version of this. I just wanted to share this idea and it could be something that if you like it, you can do yourself. It's not anything hard. I did a TikTok on it, which I shared in the beginning of this video that shows more of the process of it. I'm gonna talk about it because, it's hard to get how I did it from little 15-minute video. So I found this pattern online. It was hard actually to find a pattern that resembled what I wanted to do, something easy. People are really creative online and really good at it. I am a very, very, very much beginner sewer. I know nothing. I'm learning. My grandma was actually teaching me some stuff, and I would love to know more because I think it's such a great skill to have. But here's the stocking that I used. It's our Capuin Patterns. It's a classic stocking, which I think is the easiest thing to do. I printed it just how it is, did not scale it to fit or anything like that. Just print how it is, and then you tape the two pieces together and use that. I use this as a stencil, so I either used a pencil for the Hufflepuff ones, so light, or a permanent marker for the other ones, Gryffindor red, Ravenclaw blue, Slytherin green, because it's just easier to show up. But yeah, this made it a lot easier, so I'm so thankful for this pattern. This pattern is not mine. I found it online. I'll drop that link for you guys so you guys can see it as well. Hopefully I can find it, but yeah. I didn't want anything crazy since I really don't know how to do these things. This is really completing my Harry Potter Christmas. This is what I needed to do. It was just a nice little project to do, so yeah. As far as the material, I kind of eyeballed it, which isn't the best thing to do, but yeah, I think it was a yard of each of that felt material, which I think resembles stockings the most. And then I got the furry stuff on the top. I think we did 3 yards, which was more than enough, but it's better to be safe than sorry. I had more than enough material. I think it's better that way. Yeah, you spend money, but just in case you mess up, especially if you don't know what you're doing, I think that's even better. And plus, if you want to make some more stockings, maybe for your pets or some other loved ones, you can do that. I made one stocking of each house. And like I said, the material was more than enough. I really wanted the top part, the furry part, to be in different colors to resemble the houses, but it was way too hard to find. So we stuck with white, and it honestly looks really classy and really pretty. So, it is what it is. If you can find the material, great, without it being overly expensive. This is just a small little project. So, yeah. After you stencil this on the material, you cut it out, of course, and you cut out obviously two of these because that's what you're gonna sew. And you sew the inside of it, you turn it inside out, and there's a stocking. So just keep that in mind. I didn't really think about that when I was doing it. Thankfully, it was the same inside and out, so it didn't really matter. But just keep in mind what the inside part of the fabric is and what the outside side of the fabric is. If you're sewing and stuff. I'm sure that's not something you have to think about, but that's something I had to think about because, yeah, I use little pins to keep it together as well, and that was really helpful so it doesn't move when you're cutting and when you're sewing. It just makes it a lot easier. And also keep in mind when you want to put the furry thing on, you could sew it on the inside. I'll show you. So, this is the stocking and the patches are from Amazon. That's where I always get my patches from. And if you notice, it's sewed here. So you could go ahead and do that. So you can technically, you do the stocking beforehand and then you can sew this on after. This is some glitter that I use. It's actually really hard to do it on this material because of the texture of it. So it doesn't come out perfect, which I was really upset about because I'm a perfectionist, but it came out good enough. And the little loop, didn't even measure it, kind of eyeballed it. It's just how I live my life, I guess. And I hand stitched that onto it, and it just works perfectly. I just made sure that all the stockings were the same, in the measurements, and I kind of compared it to another stocking that I had that I didn't make, and just kind of followed the sizing for that, and I made sure it was stitched on really well so it doesn't break off. And yeah, I actually pinned it on at first to make sure when I hung it, it was perfect, and then I actually stitched it on, but I am very happy with it. It was a fun little project to do. So yeah, I just wanted to share that. I wish I would have had more of a step-by-step process of it so you could see exactly how I did it. But I didn't know how it was gonna turn out, and it was just kind of like figuring it out as you go type of thing. But if this is something you're interested in, it's just an idea. Maybe you like it and you want to use it. Yeah. Let me know in the comment section what your house is. Don't forget to subscribe for more DIY crafty content. You know I love my projects. And don't forget to like and comment.